Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. Today we are going to have our Biology Form 3, Lesson 2, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on classification 2, under the subtopic, the 5 kingdoms of classification. Remember, there are normally 5 kingdoms which are used to classify organisms. So those are the ones that we are going to look at in this lesson. But before we get into the lesson, we can have the following lesson goals, whereby by the end of the lesson, you should be able to identify the 5 kingdoms of classification, and you should also be in a position to give examples in each case. So the first kingdom that we are going to look at will be Kingdom Monera. This kingdom comprises mainly the bacteria. It comprises mainly the bacteria, and we can have different bacteria, whereby, as you can see from our diagram, we have got the coccus, we can have the diplococci, we have the staphylococci, we have streptococci, we can have the fibrio, the bacilli, the spirae. So all these bacteria belong, they all belong to kingdom Monera. So we can have now the general characteristics of kingdom Monera. Major characteristics of this kingdom is that they are unicellular and microscopic organisms. What I mean by them being unicellular is that they are made up of single cell. That is, they are single celled. Or rather, we can say they are made up of only one cell. That is, some are single cells while others are colonial. They have varied body shapes. They have actually varied body shapes, as you can see from our diagram in our screens. The second general characteristics of this kingdom is that the nuclear material is not enclosed within a nuclear membrane, hence they are said to be prokaryotic. I've said the nuclear material is not enclosed within a nuclear membrane, hence they are said to be prokaryotic. Remember, we have got other organisms which are eukaryotic. That is the opposite of this prokaryotic. The third characteristics of this kingdom is that they have cell wall but not made up of cellulose. Remember, we have got organisms whereby the cell wall is made up of the cellulose. So, but in this case of the Monera, the cell wall, their cell wall is not made up of cellulose. We can have our fourth characteristics, whereby they have few organelles. Whereby the organelles are not bound by a membrane. And their cells actually lack mitochondria. The fifth characteristic is that most of them are heterotrophic, feeding saprophytically or parasitically. Some are autotrophic. What we mean when I'm saying that most of them are heterotrophic, actually here I mean they make their own food. But we have said others are autotrophic, whereby this means they make their own food. But them being heterotrophic, it means they depend on already made food. But the ones which are autotrophic, it means that they make their own food. We can have another characteristic whereby we can say that their reproduction is mostly asexual through binary fission. Remember, we have got two types of reproduction, whereby we have the sexual and asexual. But the case of the kingdom Monera, their reproduction is asexual. Another characteristic is that most of them are anaerobes, but some respire aerobically. Remember, there are two modes of respiration, whereby the first mode is aerobic respiration and the second one is anaerobic. So we are saying that in the case of the Moneras, that is the bacteria, they can respire aerobically and also anaerobically. The last but not the least is that most of them move by use of flagella. Most of these, they move by with the aid of the flagella. The second kingdom that we are going to look at will be Kingdom Protoctista, whereby examples of this kingdom include the amoeba. We have got several several examples of all the several members of Kingdom Protoctista, whereby these are the protozoans. So we can have one example is the amoeba. We have the Chlamydomonas, as you can see from our screen, And we have also the Spirogyra. The members are very many, but this is just a representation of the examples of the protozoans. So we have said, actually the kingdom Protista is made up of the protozoans. And as you can see from our screen, these are some of the examples of the protozoans. We can now, so their general characteristics is that, we can have their general characteristics. We have one, these organisms, with varied body forms. Some are microscopic, unicellular or colonial, while others are multicellular. Then let us have the diagrammatic representation of the protozoan, so that at least you may see what I mean by saying that they have got different shapes of their body forms. As you can see, the amoeba, the chlamydomonas and the Spirogyra, they are not of the same body shape. Each one of them is having a different form of its body shape. The second characteristic is that their nuclei are membrane bound, and they are said to be eukaryotic. Actually, remember something like the kingdom Salmonella, their membrane is not membrane bound, hence they are prokaryotic. But in our case of the protozoans, we are saying that the membrane, their nucleus is bound by a membrane. That's why we are calling them eukaryotes. The third characteristics of the Protista is that they have many organelles, including mitochondria, which are membrane bound. Remember, we have said that they are eukaryotic. The another characteristic of the Protista is that some are heterotrophic, while others are autotrophic. What we mean by saying some of them are heterotrophic is that they depend on already manufactured food, either from the plants or wherever, but others make their own food. That is to mean they are autotrophic. The next characteristics of kingdom Protista is that reproduction is mainly asexual by either fission, fragmentation or sporulation. Under special condition, some reproduce sexually by conjugation. So this will mean they have got different methods of reproduction. One, we have said that they can produce asexually by one, fission, fragmentation, or by sporulation. But again, we have said that under special conditions, they can reproduce sexually. So they have, in short, they have both sexual and asexual reproduction. So the sexual reproduction is mainly through conjugation. The next characteristics of the kingdom Protista is that most they are mobile, moving by means of pseudopodia, cilia, or flagellum. So this is to mean that these protozoans actually they move, but they have got special structures of movement, whereby the structures include the pseudopodia or the cilia. Actually, as you can see from our group, in the case of the Chlamydomonas, you can see you have got the flagella. So in the case of Chlamydomonas, it is using it normally uses the flagella for movement. But others, they are not able to move. And biologically, we normally say they are sessile. Last but not the least, we can have some of them have specialized structures. Some of them have specialized structures that perform specific functions. For example, we have the contractile vacuoles for osmoregulation. As you can see from our diagrammatic representation, in case of the amoeba, it has got a contractile vacuole, whereby the contractile vacuole is normally used for osmoregulation. Having done and said that, we can have the following activity whereby you are required to give 5 characteristics of both kingdom Monera and Protista. For more information, you can refer to KLB Secondary Biology Student Book 1, that is the fourth edition. And also, you can send us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you can also send us an SMS through our Facebook page, which is Elimu TV, or you tweet us at Elimu TV _Kenya.